Hello to the viewers of NASA's channel. Welcome back to our series on the zodiac signs. As we talked in previous videos, each sign represents an area of nature, an attribute of creation, an area of life. It is very interesting to analyze the constellations as symbols or archetypes of creation, and with them, we can learn to live in a more positive and balanced way. And today, we will study the constellation of Capricorn. Capricorn is a sign ruled by the planet Saturn. The planet Saturn in the solar system is the last visible planet. Astronomers know that we can't see with the naked eye the planets that are after Saturn, and this tells us a lot about the characteristics of this planet. Saturn represents the material reality, the limitations of life. Saturn represents that teacher who teaches us to mature through difficulties. Saturn represents time. Saturn is the god Kronos of mythology. Time, that if well used, because it does not automatically bring wisdom, but time used well does bring maturity and wisdom. And when a person takes advantage of the lessons of time and matures, then he becomes an elder, which is very different than saying an old man. An elder is represented by the planet Saturn, and one who has learned from all the trials and difficult processes of life. Saturn gives the natives of Capricorn a seriousness, since it is associated with old age and with maturity. Usually, Capricorns are people who look older from a young age. Capricornian children generally have a way of being like an adult, a maturity that is not of their age. And characteristics associated with this maturity are discretion and planning. Capricornians generally like to plan things, to structure, given that Saturn represents the materiality of life. They like to plan, to structure, and to build. They are people who are responsible and hardworking. And there we see the element that rules this sign, which is Earth. As well as with the other Earth signs, Capricornians know how to build. They know how to deal with material goods. Generally, they have an ability for finances, and probably many of you have heard about Capricorn's fame of being materialistic and greedy, that they only think about money. Those are stereotypes, but those usually have their background of truth. Astrological stereotypes have something real in them. And as Capricorns are ruled by the earth element, there is a real danger for them to become materialistic people, to mischannel this element, and become people that seek all kinds of guarantees, security, car insurance, life insurance, in short, a series of guarantees for material things. They can spend their whole life working only focused on their profession, leaving the spiritual part completely forgotten. Capricorns need to learn from Pisces spirituality, that mysticism and faith in life, like Sagittarians also have, to relax and enjoy life, and to be more joyful. Because, as Saturn is a planet of seriousness, introspection, and melancholy, it can weigh on the Capricorn's character, as if they were older people, bitter and somewhat pessimistic. Capricornians have a tendency to pessimism and melancholy, and they must always be careful so that this does not take over them, to not have a pessimistic mentality or a negative mentality. They must always seek to see things on the positive side. Thus, they will control this tendency of Saturn towards pessimism and discouragement, or that tendency to think that everything must be done by us humans and that there is no divine power behind. Capricorns must recognize the divine power that acts in a mysterious way. They don't have to want to control everything or to plan everything, because there are things that need to go beyond plans. And when plans are gone and things happen in a spontaneous way, they are better. Those are the mysteries of the spiritual life, and Capricornians must learn this. Another thing I wanted to expand a bit on is the work life of a Capricornian. They have a talent for administration and know how to handle authority. Given they have a sense of maturity, they receive a certain respect and a sense of self-control. It is common to find Capricorns in management positions because they have an impulse towards career and work, and because they have a professional ethic that is usually very solid. And analyzing the complementary opposite sign, the sign of Cancer, as we talked about in the video Cancer, Cancerians are very focused on feelings, on family, on the home, and on relationships. And Capricornians need to learn this, since Capricorn represents the opposite, which is the public life. So there is a real danger that the Capricornians put too much emphasis on the career path and become absent in the family life and miss the beautiful love in relationships and friendships by focusing so much on their obligations. They need to learn the Cancerian sensitivity, to see the person who is in front of them and not the rules in the first place. They need to become more loving, because then they will counterbalance this tendency to be more practical, more pragmatic, and more rational that they have. And as we said in some videos, not all, sometimes there is an animal that represents the sign. And the animal always is related to the psychological characteristics of the natives of that sign. And in the case of the Capricorn, you can observe that it is an animal that climbs mountains, who lives in extremely steep terrain. And the life of these animals is to climb mountains, and we can see that in the Capricorn's behavior. There are people who since childhood usually have goals that they want to achieve. They even tend to scare their parents and the people around them, a child that sounds so much like an adult. And Capricornians can take care of themselves in that steep terrain. They're always looking up, focusing on their goals with a lot of perseverance, because Saturn is a strong planet of goals and discipline. That is another very important word. Capricornians have the ability to discipline themselves, and it is a planet of perseverance, so they are able to set certain goals and to pursue these goals throughout their lives, goals usually focused on career and vocation. Good. We are done for today with our astrological reflection. We hope that those who have not subscribed will subscribe to our channel. Those who have already subscribed, don't forget to activate the notification bell to be notified when a new video is uploaded with new content. And to follow our series of the Zodiac, where the next sign will be Aquarius. Thank you very much. See you then.